more down there.
I'm with you, though.
Ooh. Okay.
What I used to do when I was 8 and 10 is I would go on the iTunes store and I would just look up random words. So I would just like look up words I thought were cool to like I'd look up like iron and then I'd listen to the top 10 iron songs.
That's cool.
Yeah. And then hold on, let me check my.
You knew I was gonna do that?
Sorry. Maybe it was like Bohemian Rhapsody because I thought I was like better than everybody or something. You know?
That's awesome.
But yeah. So many bangers. I loved Maroon 5 songs about Jane. That shit was fire. I love the song Juice Box by The Strokes. That was like one of my favorites as a child.
What about rap music?
I didn't really start getting into rap until I was about like 11. So I guess that just misses the cutoff. I was like in fifth grade and I, you know, like heard like Eminem and like Look At Me Now, and there was the Busta Rhymes verse, and then I was like,
classics.
I got all tapped in with just that, and then yeah, it was just like a rabbit hole.
How old
were
you when you got your first million views?
Oh, I would say like 13.
Wow.
But I was doing FIFA videos, and so it was all like soccer, you know, it's like I can't say soccer because then they'll kill me, but football related game, and I would do like compilations of pack openings or just me opening packs, but I was what they referred to as a squeaker, where, you know, I just sounded like a girl, and so I would get very hated on. So I would try to figure out ways I could like game the system without revealing myself. Wow. You know, so I'd like do compilations, and I think I had some video that was like top 5 packs or something that got like 3 million views. Or,
wow, and at then, 13?
Yeah. But that wasn't really that significant. Like, I just had such a weird, like,
growth. Didn't mean, like, anything growth. To you, really?
When oh,
you
it did. It, I like, thought I was, like, the GOAT. I was like, nobody's compiling these FIFA packs like me, bro. I'm the GOAT of this shit. But, yeah. No, it was, I did it, like, I was obsessed with this shit. Like, I would do it every, you know, upload a video every day. And it was, like, something I was very proud of. Like, I remember I kept my YouTube a secret at school. And then I had 1,000 subscribers. And then I was like, okay, I can start like telling people the secret. And,
wow.
And that was like a thing.
What was your who or what was your introduction to? I'll say the internet, but also YouTube. I'm curious. Or realizing you could like put your own creations on the internet.
You know what's funny? This is like so niche. But this is just the truth of the world, which is that there, like, I would watch these, like, X Factor videos of, like, 11 and 10-year-olds, like, playing the piano and singing, and I was like, that's me!
Wow.
And I was like, I would hear some people playing that, and I was like, they didn't even write that shit, you know? Like, they're, like, playing Alicia Keys, and I'm like, that's Alicia Keys! Like, let's hear, like, your songs. And so then I was like, I need to do my songs, I need to put them on YouTube. So seeing that, I was like, I need to do that. So those are the first videos I ever did were me singing songs. And then that was a little too vulnerable for a middle schooler. Because if, you know, your friends find it, they're like, oh, you're, you know, and I'd sing all these forlorn ballads and, you know. So that was like a thing. And then I also love like football and soccer. Like that's my favorite. That was like my other favorite thing. Like I wore a soccer jersey every day in school till I was like 12. Like I would only wear them, so I was like very obsessed with those. What about you? Because I feel like we're kind of twizzed up in a way where I feel like we both kind of try and dabble in like the universal nature of being an artist and like a curator and all that kind of shit.
Yeah.
Like, how did you kind of see that in yourself? You know.
I grew up with my mom and my sisters, and I knew my dad, but he didn't live at the crib, so like there was no like male figure in the household, cliche story, but that was my life. And anytime my mom would point to like a black man on TV, I would become so fascinated. I'm like, okay, I'm obsessed with bro, because like my mom is like talking about how like he's lit.
Mm-hmm.
And at one point it was Will Smith. Fresh Prince was just played at my crib all the time, and I did research. My dad got me a computer.
And I looked him up and saw he was a rapper before he was an actor. I was like, I'm a rap.
Yeah, yeah.
And that was my introduction to, like, wanting to make music. And then advanced my aesthetics.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah. But I was going to say, do you have an inspiration outside of music that, like, you... that has made... they've somehow, like, made their way into your music, if that makes sense? Like, I, like...
Oh, that's a good question.
Like, I, like, a lot, and... I sometimes feel like I take some of his principles and put it into, like, the way I make music, if that...
I think I take a lot from, like, you know, film and TV.
Yeah.
Like, specific shows, like, the way that they... Like, because in a song, you're kind of, like, you have to have a convincing performance. Like, mm-hmm. even though, like, most of the time it's coming from you. Some people have songs that are really genuine, but they aren't translating... The thing. So I've always really identified with, like, building worlds and shit.
Yeah.
So any movie that kind of does that, and, like, actors that kind of get super tapped into shit. Like, I like Robert Pattinson. And I like, yeah. I like Larry David. Even though I'm not sure how much that makes it into my music. Makes into my life. Larry yeah. David.
Really?
Yeah.
In what ways?
I don't know. I just think that I try and watch as much Curb Your Enthusiasm as I can when I'm sad, because there's kind of like a way of viewing life through that show, like through the lens of that show, that just makes that like softens like everything in a good way. That's like funny. I was really depressed and like last year, and for a month straight I just listened to Action Bronson's discography on loop and watch Curb Your Enthusiasm clips, and then I was fixed. So that's what, now you're asking me if I would go to therapy. That's what I do.
That's awesome.
But I don't know. That was just a ramble because I couldn't think of a good answer. This is beautiful.
Yeah, for real.
Do you think about like making magnum opuses? Like, do you have like this lingering idea in the back of your head, or like this desire to like, you're like, oh, I have this like project that I need to do that's like gonna be the thing? Or do you have multiple versions of those, or do you kind of approach your process in more of like day by day or like idea by idea basis, and then it amounts to like a catharsis that is like good, you know? Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do. I think I always am trying to have that, my magnum opus.
Yeah.
Every time. But even when I was in high school, like, making my first real mixtape that I wanted to put out, I was like, you know, this has to be as good as whatever my favorite artist at the time, like, their debut album was.
I'm sure there's, like, a million people that are like, I want to have that career. Like, your career path is also inspiring to me.
Thank you.
You know? That's so that's another reason why this is cool and surreal. Because, like, I've been, you know, inspired by your solo work and Brockhampton and all that shit, and it's like, it's funny that on the project that you have, that we have the song that closes the project, like there's like songs that are like very obviously Brockhampton inspired, and so it's kind of cool
that's
that
really
it's
cool.
Like, and I was making them without any foresight that we would end up linking and like making cool stuff, you
that's
know?
So sick.
But yeah, I don't know.
I did an interview the other day with Alt Press, and they brought up Dead Air somehow. I forgot how. Maybe I talked about going to the Jane show, but like, just the vibe and the feeling of a movement with like original music and real creativity is so awesome to me.
Yeah.
It's like, it's the only thing I want to be around usually.
Hell
but
yeah.
That's like, that's really how I tapped in with you. Like, just, you're so consistent too.
Thank you.
And very, it feels prolific, but it feels like curated and like well timed. Like it doesn't feel like you're rushing shit out.
Yeah.
How do you balance that?
I've become good at holding myself accountable for my long term vision. Like as soon as I have like this idea, like I'm working on my next album right now, and I'm like, I know what it's capable of being right now, and I'm gonna hold myself accountable to make sure that it's as good as the best version of it in my head.
Right.
You know?
Right.
But that's very nice of you to say. And that's cool. What I'm aiming for. Like, I'm aiming for, like, consistency, but never like redundancy, you know, like, yeah. like everything is bringing something new to the table, and it's like pushing something forward and adding like a new branch to me, you know? And I think, yeah, that's like what's like exciting. Like, that's like what makes me happy to like do that, or like, to crack something new where I'm like, fuck, I feel like nobody's done that.
Right.
And like, you know, it's the trade-off of like being a spectacle, and like, I you have to kind of accept what comes with that, and also what it takes away from you, you know, if you want to like have your shit, you know, reach what it can be. And I kind of feel as though like I value like music and what I make more than myself, and so I'm okay with that, you know.
The GOAT, if anybody doesn't know, this is the GOAT, Jane Remover.
Let's fucking
go. Self-produced.
I would not say that.
Genius. 100%. You wouldn't say that?
The GOAT.
You're the GOAT, self-produced genius?
I'm not there yet.
What?
There,
but, no, but you are.
You've set up the pathway to GOAThood, you know? At least.
GOAThood.
Yeah.
What's a baby GOAT?
Baby GOAT.
A gruff? I might be tripping.
Oh. Baby GOAT.
A baby GOAT. Like, what are you...
Baby goes hard.
Aren't they like called fawns or something?
Yeah, maybe fawns. A fawn.
Yeah. If
you could speak another language. Do you speak another language?
I tried learning Spanish. Like in high school, in college, I learned Spanish and I forgot most of it. I can pronounce it. Like if you put Spanish words on a paper for me, I can like pronounce them okay.
Yeah.
But yeah. I don't know what like I forgot what most of the words mean.
If you could pick a new language, like any language to know.
A new language?
Yeah.
Ooh. You know, like Scots?
Like Scotland?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I'm gonna learn that.
Here, I'll speak it to you right now. You ready?
Do you know it?
Yeah, it's how you say it. Everybody's fucking staring at you. They're all fucking staring at your breasts. What about you, Ian? What's the language are you picking?
Spanish.
Jane, what do you hope happens after you die?
Ooh. Do you know like the... I forgot what it was called. It was like quantum universe theory, blah blah, infinite. I don't know. Where it's like you have probably already died like 1,000 times, but you're just like in the universe that you don't.
Oh.
You know? So what if you just like live forever type shit? You know?
That's kind of crazy.
I would fuck with that.
Let's find out.
Oh, shit. Can we head back to the crib?
Let's go.
Let's do it. Superstar caliber. Just incredible in so many ways. Just like truly an inspiration. That's why everyone who's like the GOAT says that Jane's the GOAT. So what could that mean? You know? It could only really mean one thing.
That's awesome.
That means Stream Census Designated.
Hey.
And the album to come.
Hey.
And Frailty, because that's an amazing album too.
Let's go.
Boom.
That is so nice.
Wait, so how many new songs come out tonight?
Seven.
Seven, okay.
Wow. There's only one that matters.
Hey.